Hi, welcome to Genius Lounge. I'm your host, Matt Troutman. Here at Genius Lounge, we take technology and we make it accessible to mere mortals. So you might be one of those people that if you meet someone new, you like to exchange contact information. It's a great way to network and it also helps you keep in touch. However, if you've met a new business online, you may not want to share all of your contact information with them because one, you may not know if they're reputable or not, and also it may be nearly impossible to unsubscribe from their email newsletters. So, Apple introduced a new feature called Hide My Email with iCloud Plus. iCloud Plus is Apple's paid version of iCloud, which you can find information on apple.com. Now, Hide My Email generates a random email address that you can provide to a company when you're signing up for an account or a newsletter, and they can email you there and you can respond, and it all keeps your email address hidden from them. However, you don't have to do any extra work. The best part here is that it's built into Apple's mail applications and also built into Safari so that when you're signing up for forms, it offers you the ability to hide my email. So let's take a look at how this works. I'm going to show you on a phone and then I'm going to show you how it works on a Mac as well. So let's go ahead and open up Safari. I've already loaded up WordPress.com where we're trying to create an account. So in this first field, they're asking for our email address. Now we can also see down here that I can click on Continue with Apple. And when I do that, it brings up this panel that allows me to create an account very easily. So I can say I'd like to use my name and I can either share my email address with this company or I can hide it and they'll generate a random email and then forward those emails to my real email address. So for right now, I'm going to go ahead and tell it cancel because I want to show you how when you're filling out a form on another website or say signing up for an email newsletter, it's easy to use Hide My Email. In here, it's asking for my email. I can see that I can fill that from my contact or I can click on Hide My Email. When I do that, you'll see this pop up and it's going to generate a random email address for me and I'm going to go ahead and tell it use. So now that email address is active and I can use this to create my account and I can tap create account and I can go on creating that account with WordPress. At this point, I'm going to stop, however, and I want to show you one other thing. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Mail. When I get in here, if I go down to the lower right, I'm going to compose a new message. I can compose this to, let's say, tim@example.com. And then when I tap in the from field here, I can choose, instead of my real email address, I can choose hide my email. And at that point, it's going to generate a random email for me. And then I can say hello. I can send that message. So now that we've created the emails, now we want to be able to control them. So say we signed up for an email newsletter and we've asked them to unsubscribe us, but they're not honoring that request. So what you can do is you can actually turn off the email. We're going to go to our settings. You'll tap on your name and it's in iCloud settings here. Unfortunately, it's buried a little deep. All right, we're going to tap on hide my email. And then I can scroll down here and I can say, oh, here's my new WordPress email, or here's the tim@example.com that we just created. And I can say, I would like to deactivate this email address. And it says, you'll stop receiving emails sent to this email address. You can reactivate it from inactive addresses. If I deactivate this, it's no longer going to receive emails. And I can also come down here and look at inactive addresses and see that that isn't my only one now. If I tap on it here, I can choose to either reactivate the address or I can delete it altogether. All right, so that's how to do all of this on an iPhone. Now let's take a look at how to do this on a Mac. All right, so once again, here we are and I'm at WordPress.com and I'm creating a new account. I can click in here again and just like before, I see hide my email pop up right in that field. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose that. I get this little account panel again and it's telling me this is what my new email address is going to be. If I don't like the looks of this one, I can also rotate this. You can do this on the phone as well, and you can choose that you don't like one, and it'll give you about three or four different options. So in this case, I'm gonna go ahead and tell it use. It fills that in, and then now I can go ahead and create my account. All right, so now if we come in here and we're going to create an email, I can open up Mail, click on the Compose icon here, and I can say I'd like this to go to bob@example.com. There we go. And once again, I can choose Hide My Email, and it's going to go out and get that random email address for me. And I can go ahead and say this is a test, and I can send that message. Now, if I needed to adjust these email settings, like I wanted to deactivate one of them, all I need to do is open my system preferences, and I'm going to open up my Apple ID, and there we see Hide My Email again. You choose options, and then you see all of these different email addresses that it's created. So in this case, here's WordPress, and I can scroll down here just a bit, and I can tell it I'd like to deactivate that. All right, so that's how you use the Hide My Email feature on your Mac and on your iPhone. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please be sure to give us a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to get more videos like this, ring the bell so that way you get notifications whenever we post new videos. Thanks so much. I'm Matt Troutman, and I hope to see you around the Genius Lounge.